Hello everybody, this is Jason from 611connect.com, and today I'm going to review the Motorola CLIQ XT, available right now from T-Mobile. Firstly, this phone is pretty ugly. Everything from the logo, to the buttons, to the screen, feels pretty out of balance. Having said that though, this phone feels pretty sturdy. The brushed plastic on the front and the rubber pattern on the back are very nice to the touch and don't get slippery at all. Also on the back, you'll find a 5 megapixel camera with an LED flash. There's also a headphone jack up top, centered just like the old iPods. Back on the front, you'll find an optical trackpad right here that also acts as a selecting button, and the four standard Android buttons, menu, find, home, and back. There's also an activity LED right here above the screen. Inside, you'll find the biggest disappointment of this phone. When every other HTC phone at the moment runs Android 2.1, this run runs version 1.5 with Moto Blur. It doesn't even have the turn-by-turn Google Maps. Come on. It also lags like crazy, with an extremely underpowered processor, even for this outdated version of Android. And Moto Blur. Moto Blur became obsolete for most users about 4 iterations of Facebook ago. Most people's news feeds nowadays are way too complicated and dense for Blur to make anything useful out of it. So what comes out is a mashup of everything that you don't want to read about friends that you don't care about. But it also has some positives. The Moto Blur service allows you to track your phone if it gets lost. And the status update tool works pretty well if you're very active on social networks. I also lament for a better touchscreen and a physical keyboard with this device. I also long for a better touchscreen or a physical keyboard with the CLIQ XT. Swipe works pretty well in most cases. When it comes to typing symbols or numbers individually, it's absolutely abysmal with this small of a touchscreen. T-Mobile's underrated 3G network is pretty fast. It's just not live everywhere at the moment. Android 1.5 also keeps you from using really cool apps that would utilize the 3G, like Google Goggles. Thankfully though, this phone has great call quality, 3G or not. Unfortunately though, the battery isn't up to par, with the phone needing a charge usually after 3/4 of a workday. In conclusion, if this phone had a bigger touchscreen and Android 2.1, I'd probably recommend it. But it'd also probably be called the HTC Evo 4G instead. For the price point, though, it makes a great first smartphone. Thanks for watching, everybody. This is Jason from 611connect.com.